हेलो ऑल, वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल। सो नाउ वी विल गो ऑन कॉल्स इन अरियर्स एंड कॉल्स इन एडवांस। वी आर ऑन कंपनी इशू ऑफ शेयर्स एंड हियर देर इज दिस टॉपिक कॉल्स इन अरियर्स एंड कॉल्स इन एडवांस। लेट अस फर्स्ट अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज कॉल्स इन अरियर्स एंड व्हाट आर कॉल्स इन एडवांस। सो कॉल्स इन अरियर्स मीन्स दैट द कंपनी हैज कॉल्ड अप सम अमाउंट एंड द शेयर होल्डर हैज नॉट पेड। What word did I use? The amount is due. The company has called up. See, let me tell you what I'm trying to say. Suppose there is application money, there is allotment money, there is first call and second call. So, say suppose up till now the company has called up the application money, allotment money and first call. Second call has not yet been called up. सेकेंड कॉल का पैसा कंपनी ने मंगवाया ही नहीं है तो इसे कॉल्स इन अरियर्स नहीं बोलते। व्हाट इज कॉल्स इन अरियर्स? सपोज अ शेयर होल्डर डिड नॉट पे अलॉटमेंट मनी और सपोज अ शेयर होल्डर डिड नॉट पे द फर्स्ट कॉल मनी, द कंपनी हैज कॉल्ड अप दैट अमाउंट, कंपनी हैज मेड दैट अमाउंट ड्यू, बट इफ द शेयर होल्डर हैज नॉट पेड देन इट इज कॉल्ड एज कॉल्स इन अरियर्स। अरियर्स इन द वन सेंस मीन्स रिसीवेबल। सो फ्रॉम कंपनीज पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू दिस अमाउंट इज रिसीवेबल। ओके, एंड now coming on to calls in advance. So calls in advance is there are shareholders who pay call money in advance only. So here what is happening, amount is not due, the company has not yet called up the amount, but shareholder has paid in advance. This is calls in advance. So in the same example which we take now, here what did I say? Application, allotment and call money, first call was called up. Second call is not called up yet, but suppose there is a shareholder who pays application, allotment, first call and he also pays second call. So this second call amount which he has paid, this is calls in advance. Okay. Today we learn on how to do journal entries when there is calls in arrears and calls in advance. Along with this, one more thing let me point out first. There is interest on calls in arrears and interest on calls in advance. Interest on calls in arrears as per table F of Companies Act, table F of Articles of Association, interest on calls in arrears is charged at 10%. Let us understand what is this. See, calls in arrears is what? Calls in arrears is where a shareholder has not paid when the company called up that amount. So what is happening? Company ne paisa mangwaya, shareholder ne pay nahi kiya, to company interest on calls in arrears charge karegi. Charge karegi matlab charged by company. It is an income for the company. This is a income. Whereas when I come up to calls in advance, so what happens to this income? The company says that whenever now you pay the call amount, you are late in paying. Whenever you now pay the call amount, then at that time you'll also have to pay the interest amount. Okay. Coming on to interest on calls in advance. Interest on calls in advance. Now let us first understand. See, in calls in advance, what is happening? Shareholder has paid the amount in advance, which the company has not yet called. कंपनी ने वो पैसा मंगवाया नहीं बट शेयर होल्डर ने पे कर दिया। इन दिस केस द अमाउंट इज रिसीव्ड इन एडवांस, हियर द कंपनी विल हैव टू पे। सो आई कैन राइट पेड बाय कंपनी। सो इंटरेस्ट ऑन कॉल्स इन एडवांस इज पेड बाय द कंपनी। ओके, नाउ इन सच अ केस टेबल एफ सेज दैट इंटरेस्ट ऑन कॉल्स इन एडवांस विल बी एट 12%, and this is an expense of the company. The company will have to pay. Okay, so now I'm taking up one of the question which is in CA Foundation revision test papers. We say RTP. So I'm taking one of the question from RTPs, and we'll directly understand the whole concept using that question. Let us proceed. This is the question. Pihu Limited issued at par. Again the same thing. First read the question full very nicely. Next step is to write up the main points from the question in my answer sheet. And then I'll not have to read the question again. I'll properly understand and write in my working notes. And then I can directly go on to the solution. Let us read. So Pihu Limited issued at par 2 lakh equity shares of 10 each. Payable at 2.5 on application, 3 on allotment, two on first call and balance on final call. So here first I'll have to understand that how much goes in the final call. We'll see. All the shares were fully subscribed. So this is a case of full subscription. That means the entire 2 lakh shares were applied and allotted. Also, they have clearly mentioned it is issued at par. So there is no premium. Okay. Then they have said Mr. Pal, who held 20,000 shares, paid full remaining amount on first call itself. Okay. So he's paying the remaining amount on first call itself. The final call, which was made after 3 months from first call, was fully paid, except a shareholder having 2,000 shares who paid his due amount after 2 months along with interest on calls in arrears. Okay. Company also paid interest on calls in advance to Mr. Pal. You are required to prepare journal entries to record these transactions. Okay. Let us understand. So, how many shares are being issued? So, PU Limited issued at par 2 lakh 80 shares of 10 each. Now, I am on my working note. Now I am on my working note and it is 2 lakh shares are being issued of 10 each. So the face value is 10 and it is issued at par. There is no premium, right? Okay. 2.5 on application, 3 on allotment, 2 on first call and balance on final call. So let us just write. Application amount is 2.5, right? It was 2.5. Yes, 3 on allotment. Allotment amount is 3. First call is, how much is there on first call? First call, 2 on first call and balance on final call. 2 on first call. So how can I take out the balance? See, you know that the total has to come to 10. Correct. Here the total is 3 plus 2, 5 plus 2.5, 7.5. That means 2.5 is the balance. I hope you all understood. These three figures were given. I subtracted this from 10 because here the shares are issued at par. So I got that final call money is 2.5. Okay. I'll just rub this part. Okay. Then what else is the question saying? Now the question says Mr. Pal and they were fully subscribed. Okay. Mr. Pal, who held 20,000 shares, paid full remaining amount on first call itself. So let us mark first call because here I'm just marking and I'll just write that. Okay. Here Mr. Pal will pay on 20,000 shares the final call amount also. Final call amount will also be paid. I'm just writing it. This will be calls in advance. Okay. And next they are saying the final call which was made after 3 months. Now why is these detail given? Because they have told about interest also. So interest we'll take later on in the last part. So I'm right now ignoring the 3 months. I'll be taking this at the time of calculation of interest. Okay. So the final call which was made after 3 months from first call was fully paid except a shareholder having 2000 shares who paid his due amount after 2 months. That means this person, at the time of final call, he did not pay 2000 shares his calls in arrears, which they are saying that he will pay after 2 months. Again, here this 2 months will I'll be taking at the time of interest calculation, not now. Then what else the question says? Company paid interest on calls in arrears and calls in advance. You are required to prepare journal entries. Okay, so let us move on to our journal entries now. We know that at the time of application, first entry is of received, next entry is of due or transfer to share capital. This question is comparatively easy because here there is no premium, there is no oversubscription, no undersubscription. So received amount would be 2 lakh into 2.5. 2 lakh into 2.5. How much ever you are confident with the calculations, I always prefer that do it mentally, but also check it with your calculator so that there is no scope of mistake. My only reason of always telling you all to check things is so that don't make a mistake. Keep on checking your sums. Don't be overconfident any point of time. And the same amount will be transferred. Okay, so this entire 5 lakh, 2 lakh into 2.5 will be transferred to share capital. Let us do the first entries. One thing at a time. Always remember. Okay. Here again, dates are not given, so we will not bother much about the dates. So we will just write in the books of पीहू लिमिटेड, जर्नल एंट्रीज, आई शुड राइट इट डाउन बट यू आर आई एम मिसिंग आउट ऑन स्पेस, दैट इज वाई एम राइटिंग. एंड दिस क्वेश्चन इज फ्रॉम वन ऑफ द आर टी पीज, रिविजन टेस्ट पेपर ऑफ आई सी ए आई सी इंस्टीट्यूट. ओके, सो इंस्टेड ऑफ डेट आई कैन राइट सीरियल नंबर. ओके, फर्स्ट एंट्रीज ऑफ शेयर एप्लीकेशन मनी रिसीव्ड, बैंक अकाउंट डेबिट टू इक्विटी शेयर एप्लीकेशन अकाउंट, एंड वी जस्ट नाउ डिस्कस द अमाउंट इज 2 lakh into 2.5 विच इज 5 lakhs. I did discuss this in the last video that always it's better to show your, though I'm showing in working note, but you can write if you have space in particular so that you don't make a mistake in the zeros. And in case even if you make a mistake in the zeros, then here the examiner can see that, okay, you know the solution, only that's a silly mistake of zeros. So always show your workings clearly so that silly mistakes can be avoided from your point. Okay. The journal entry would be being application money received. Being application money received. Next entry is of due or transfer to share capital. So now this equity share application amount would be transferred to equity share capital account. Okay. Same 5 lakh. 5 lakh. You can just write being application amount transferred to share capital account. Okay, coming on to point number 3. Now, let's go on to the working first. Okay, again in case of allotment, first I will do the entry of due now. Only in case of application, we do the entry of received. Rest in all the three cases, we first do the entry of due and second is the entry of received. Okay. So, I know, see, I mentioned in the question, I have to think more in the time of, at the time of first call and final call. Here at the time of allotment, I don't have to think much. I can clearly proceed. So, here 2 lakh into 3, 6 lakhs. Both way, in both the entries, amount would be 6 lakh. Okay. So my third entry will be, first is entry of due, equity share allotment account debit, equity share allotment account debit to equity share capital account, and the amount is 2 lakh into 3 which is 6 lakhs. This is being allotment amount due. Next entry is of received, bank account debit to equity share allotment. Same amount we have received, so 6 lakhs and 6 lakhs. This will be being allotment amount received. Done. I hope up till here you guys must not be having any doubts. In case you have doubt, then you can surely contact me on the number given in the details description. Okay, now coming on to first call, pay attention, see what happened at the time of first call. At the time of first call, the question says that one person, Mr. Pal, here Mr. Pal, who held 20,000 shares, paid full remaining amount on first call itself. You need to understand that first call, see, when we'll call, now again in case of first call, there'll be first entry of due or transfer. So that you will be calling on 2 lakh shares and the amount is 2 rupees, 2 lakh into 2, 4 lakh, correct? So there is this shareholder, Mr. Pal, who is paying first call, but along with that, he is also paying his final call. How much is the final call? Final call is 2.5. So he is paying extra 20,000 into 2.5. 20,000 into 2.5, which is 50,000. दिस 50,000 इज एक्स्ट्रा. ही इज पेइंग हिज फर्स्ट कॉल अमाउंट बट अलॉन्ग विद दैट ही इज पेइंग 50,000 एक्स्ट्रा विच इज अ फाइनल कॉल विच इज नॉट येट कॉल्ड बट ही इज गिविंग दिस इज कॉल्ड कॉल्स इन एडवांस. सो इन माई रिसीव्ड वेन आई डू द एंट्री रिसीव्ड आई विल बी रिसीविंग 6 लाख सॉरी 4 2 2 4 लाख. So I'll receive 4 lakh plus I will also receive 50,000 calls in advance, which is 4,50,000. Let us go on to the entry. Okay. So my entry will become equity share for the due or transfer entry. You don't have to think much. Equity share first call account debit to equity share capital. Amount would be, how many shares are there? So there are 2 lakh shares and first call amount is 2, right? So 2 lakh into 2 will be 4 lakh. We've already written, but I'm just writing it again. 4 lakh. And this, the narration would be being share first call account amount due. This is the entry of due. And now when we will receive, so see here is itself is my, so I am receiving 50,000 extra, right? So now my entry would be C, bank account debit. Understand, I am receiving 4 lakh plus 50,000, which is 4,50,000. 2, equity share first call you have debited with 4 lakh, so it will be credited with the same amount. Equity share first call will be credited with 4 lakh, and this 50,000 is called as calls in advance account. Okay, why is it coming on the credit side? Because it's a liability. It's a liability to the company. Liabilities are being credited. Now you look, say, why is it a liability? Because see, you've not called for that amount, but the shareholder has already paid. So it is a liability for us. When does it become our actual income or actual money taken? When the company calls for the final call amount. So this calls in advance would be 50,000. And narration you can simply write being share first call amount received. Now like I told you, in narration you can write along with calls in advance. If you want to write, you can write. But narrations short and sweet are okay. No one will cut your marks for writing a less of narration. Writing narration is important, but not necessary to write entire thing. Our entry is enough to show what we are wanting to say. Okay, now coming on to our last and final call. See, final call. Again, for final call, you do the entry of due. So, due would be 2 lakh into 2.5, which is 5 lakh. And you do the entry of received. Now, understand, what will I receive? See, I should receive, the company should receive 5 lakh, correct? This is very important, pay attention. Final call amount should be received 5 lakh, correct? But Mr. Pal has already paid his 50,000 before this 50,000. So Mr. Pal has paid 50,000 before itself. So now will I receive it again? No, I'll not receive. So I should receive 4 lakh 50, correct? But in case of final call, they've mentioned that this person, there was another shareholder who did not pay 2000 shares, who did not pay the amount on 2000 shares. That means he did not pay 2000 into 2.5, which comes to 5000. He did not pay 5000. This 5000 is also not paid. This is nothing but calls in arrears. And thus, how much did we actually receive? We receive only 4,45,000 amount. Okay. Let's do the entry and understand it better. So now first I'll do the entry of due or transfer. Again, I told you, don't think much at the time of this entry. So you can just write equity share final call account debit. That would be 2 lakh into 2.5, which is 5 lakh. 2, equity share capital account. 5 lakh. Being final call amount due. And the next entry, the most important entry, would be bank debit. Now see, in case, now here in our working note, if you see properly, we've already taken out on how much amount will be received at a time of when we do the entry of bank. But let us suppose if you guys are not able to understand how to calculate this, then with your journal entries also you can do it. How? Let me tell you. See, this calls in advance, which was credited, it was our liability. Till when is it our liability? It is our liability till the time the company has not called up the amount. Now the company has called up the amount, but I have already received. So this calls in advance, which was credited, will now be debited. So I will debit calls in advance ₹50,000. Okay. This figure, where is it coming? It is coming from here. It is coming from here. Okay. And like calls in advance is credit because it's our liability. Calls in arrears is debit. Calls in arrears have a debit balance. Why? Because it's our asset. We are supposed to receive the money. We've not received up till now, but we'll be receiving it soon. So calls in arrears is my asset, and calls in arrears is 5,000. And this equity share final call, which was debited by 5 lakh, it should be credited by 5 lakh. Equity share final call will be credited by 5 lakh. So now you know that after each journal entry, your debit and credit has to match. In your credit, you have 5 lakh, and in your debit, you have 55,000. You will subtract. So again, you will get the same figure, 4,45,000 as the balancing figure. So in case, see, this is again a way of checking. I did my working note, I got 445. Again, I saw here, I got 445. These were the entries for calls in arrears and calls in advance. Now, what is remaining is the interest. Let us now calculate the interest. Let us go on our working note again. See, we said that interest on, first I'm doing calls in advance because the calls in advance account is already open, already closed. So interest on calls in advance is at what percentage? I already told you, it is at 12%. Also, interest on calls in advance, is it an income or an expense? It's an expense for the company. So let us first calculate how much is the interest. Now for this, I'll have to calculate the months. I'll have to look at the months. Okay. So interest on, they are saying Mr. Pal, who held 20,000 shares, paid full remaining amount on first call. The final call, which was made 3 months from first call. That means this amount was with us, with the company, extra for 3 months. So interest will be calculated on amount of calls in advance was 50,000. 50,000 into 12% per annum into 3 by 12. So you will get interest figure as 1500. Okay. Let us do the entry quickly. Then we'll go on to interest on calls in arrears. So my entry, since interest on calls in arrears, calls in advance is my expense, interest on calls in advance will be debited. Interest on calls in advance debit, it's an expense to shareholder. First you show the entry of due. Again, to shareholder, we took out that the amount comes to 1500, and later on this amount will be paid. Let me just, so when this amount is paid, you can just write being interest on calls in advance due. Okay. And now when the company pays it, entry would be shareholder account debit to bank account. This is the entry of payment, 1500. Getting it? You'll write being interest paid. Okay. Now coming on to interest on calls in arrears. When we talk about interest on calls in arrears, we know now that the rate as per table F is 10% per annum. Okay. And how much was the calls in arrears amount? So the calls in arrears amount was 5,000. Okay. So 5,000 into 10% into. Now let us check, when did that shareholder pay us the amount back? When he'll pay the amount, along with that, he'll pay interest. This is what we assume. So they are saying fully paid except a shareholder having 2000 shares who paid his due amount after 2 months along with interest on calls in arrears. They've clearly said that he paid after 2 months along with interest on calls in arrears. Okay, so 2 by 12. When you calculate this, you will get 5000 into 10% into 2 divided by 12, which comes to 83.33. So let us just round it up to 83. So I'm just rounding out it at 83. I'm not doing 83.33. Now, look, again, these entries are important. First, I'll make lines. Okay. So first would be my entry of what was the serial number? 11th. First, let me do the entry due for interest on calls in arrears. Interest on calls in arrears, now that is our income. So our entry would become shareholder account debit. Our amount came to 83. To interest on calls in arrears. This we did the entry of due. If you want, you all can do a combined entry, but right now, since I'm explaining, I'm not doing a combined entry. So being interest on calls in arrears receivable. Calls in arrears receivable. And now, once you receive the amount, your last entry will become C. Again, very important. Bank account debit. How much are we receiving? Understand. Calls in arrears amount was 5000. So we are receiving this amount, 5000. And along with this, we are receiving the interest also. So you will do 50. So your entry will now become 5083. Okay. Also, one thing. Here, calls in arrears was debited. This account was debited as it was my asset. Now I'm receiving the money. So I'll have to close this account. Now calls in arrears would be credited. Calls in arrears would be credited by 5000. The account gets closed. And this shareholder account, which we had debited, will now be credited. So while I was saying you can do a combined entry, what you can do is interest on instead of shareholder debit, this entry, this 11th entry can be skipped and you could have written interest on calls in arrears here itself. But it's always better to go systematically and write it like this. 83 being calls in arrears received along with interest. Received along with interest. Okay. So this is all about interest on calls in arrears and calls in advance. Hope you all are understanding. And like I've told you, if you have any doubt, feel free to contact. See you soon in the next video where we'll be discussing about forfeiture of shares. Again, a very important part. So stay tuned with me. Thank you.